Go ahead, guys.
Just with, you know, everything going on at the beginning of the season, just how are you right now and where's your mindset?
I'm rolling, man. We won 3 in a row, trying to get to 4 in a row, and yeah. As all the attention comes, it feels like, you know, I was on top of the world after the Super Bowl, and right now even more on top of the world. So it's fun, man.
Travis, the level of attention that's been the last couple of weeks with everything with Taylor, what has that been like to process for you, and even including things like actual paparazzi and all this? How are you managing that?
No, we're learning with the paparazzi, just taking photos from all over the place, but. At the same time, it's you know, it comes with it. It comes with it. You got a lot of people that care about Taylor, and for good reason. So it's you know, just got to keep living and learning and enjoying the moments. And at the end of the day, you know, I've always been pretty good about compartmentalizing and being able to stay focused in this building. So I'll just keep rolling with that, man.
Does being in this building kind of help you a lot to get away from everything else?
I think it's always been that for me. You know, no matter what's going on in my life, good or bad. You know, I think this is one place I can get away and just be locked in and focused, and always check myself and my ego at the door and make sure that I come in with a clear mind.
What have you learned about the size and scope of her world, the entertainment world?
It's worldwide, man. It's worldwide. I just, it's been magnified for sure, though.
Travis, playing in that first game in Jacksonville, what was the toughest part, and where do you feel like you've come through since then?
The toughest part for me was to just get back in the groove, you know, with the knee injury and everything going into that week, or coming out of the Lions week in week one. There's been that aspect, and then on top of that, as a whole, as a unit, just staying on the page for 4 quarters, staying, you know, together for 4 quarters, together as an offense specifically, and just nonstop trying to get better, man. That's always been the goal.
Travis, what's Patrick like coming off of a week where he feels like
he's dialed in, man. He's dialed in. He's one of the best quarterbacks to ever do this thing because of how he can move on from things, how he can learn from things, and make sure that he's just, you know, being the best he can for the guys around him and the organization he's in front of. So it's just I expect him to go out there and beat Pat Mahomes, baby. Nothing less.
This seems like a ridiculous task, but what do you think of Aaron Rodgers calling you?
I thought it was pretty good. I mean, with the stash right now, I look like a guy named Mr. Pfizer. Who knew I'd get into the vax wars with Aaron Rodgers, man? Mr. Pfizer versus the Johnson & Johnson family over there, man.
I don't think we asked you about it since you're in the commercial. Can you kind of just say why you wanted to do that?
I mean, I've always been, you know, once I got the vaccine, I got it because of, you know, keeping myself safe, keeping my family safe, the people in this building. So, yeah, I stand by it 1,000% and fully comfortable with him calling me Mr. Pfizer.
Travis, anything you've seen in the first quarter of the season from other defenses that they might be playing differently than the years past that you've just seen this particular season?
I mean, it's there might be they might have focused in on a few things at least up to this, you know, time frame in the season. You know, Coach Flores is an unbelievable defensive coordinator, or defensive coach, I should say, just a coach in general, and I got a lot of respect for him. And I know that he's not shy of bringing the heat and putting the pressure on you, and we just got to be ready for it, man.
Travis, how rare is it that you and Patrick maybe aren't on the same page? When I think there was one play last week, it looked like you guys were.
There was a few plays, and it's just, you know, we're still learning, we're still trying to figure things out and trying to make the best decisions. You know, it's one thing when it goes right. And then you want to do something based off of what you just did, knowing that the defense saw it, right? So it's just nonstop playing chess with the guys across from you, and you just got to make sure you're on the same page and you're not putting the team in a tough spot, or putting Pat in a tough spot like it did last week a few times.
As much as you guys are seeming to read each other's minds, does it seem really crazy when it doesn't work, or is it just the way it is?
I think that's a good question. I'm really just so focused in on the success of the drive, the success of the play, how that play ends, and then on top of that, being able to move on from it and learn from it. So it's just, you never really get caught up in, you know, getting down on it, that's for sure.
Blended happy birthday, by the way.
Thank you.
Now that you're, I hate to say 34, I mean.
Why do you hate to say that?
Are you feeling
34? I'm very fortunate to get to 34, man, and to be able to do what I love, man. I got a lot of shout outs from family, friends, a lot of people reaching out yesterday. Chiefs Kingdom always shows love, and it's just it's an appreciating day, you know. As much as everybody wants to make it about me, I just see how much family and friends that I have that I have around me, and it's always a beautiful thing.
Do you feel like things get harder? I mean, are you noticing that at this point in your career that it's a little bit more difficult between training camp and a knee injury, that there's more difficulties physically?
There's been some things that have popped up that just make you stay on top of it, man. I think everybody gets to this point in their career, or if they're fortunate enough to get to year 11 in their career, you definitely got to start to hone in on things even more and just make sure that you're available, you know. Make sure that you're doing everything you can to make yourself available. And that's always been the mindset for sure.
Matt?
Travis, this is the longest you've had the mustache into the season.
Yeah.
Is this always the plan, or how did this work out?
Yeah, it feels smooth, man. It feels good, man. Just got a cut this morning, if you couldn't tell. And I feel the power out there when I'm running routes, for sure.
Mackenzie?
Yeah, the last 2 weeks, it seems like the Chiefs games were also known as, like, Taylor watch. People want to know if she's coming to the game, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
How do you kind of tune that out? I know you mentioned on your podcast that it seemed like they were overdoing it a little bit with the cutaway shots, everybody, you know, having their eyes on her.
Everybody's having fun with it, yeah. You know. Whether I think they're overdoing it or not, you know I brought this to myself, or I've been fortunate enough to have fun with it, you know. And that's where all that really matters, is that it's not pissing anybody off. Over here, at least. So I'm having fun with it. And I think that, like I said earlier, I've been pretty good at just compartmentalizing and making sure my focus is always about, you know, winning the game. And I don't see that changing anytime soon.
We'll go last two, PJ, and then Nate. Go, PJ.
Jarvis, it feels like you've had a lot of self-reflection just right now with everything going on. Is that part of your birthday, or is that just, how often do you self-reflect?
I'm fortunate, man. A lot of my home games, I have a lot of family and friends come in town, and that's almost like a birthday every single week. You know, especially when we get a win, because I think it's a 20-person suite, so you got at least 20 people coming in to see you specifically play, you know, the game you've been playing since you were a kid. There's a bit of a birthday feel to that when you get the family and friends around. So it's just I'm always reflecting on how appreciative I am of, you know, the people around me, knowing that I grew up with a great community. I grew up with a great group of friends that I'm still close with, and on top of that, we grabbed a lot of good ones along the way.
Nate?
Travis, we talked to Pat last week about the touchdown where you made the decision to change the route. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you know all the route concepts. I just wonder, when you hear the play call, how much do you sort of anticipate yourself maybe saying, if the look looks a little bit differently, I'm going to do maybe what's different than on the page?
Most of that is talked about, or at some point has been talked about in another route concept, and it will mirror up with Pat. I think for the most part, the flow of the game, the feel of the game. I've had so much fun with 1-5 outside the facility. You know, I've seen that guy compete in everything from golf to pickleball to beer pong, you name it, man.
Right.
And so I get what his competitive nature is. And I think that goes a lot further than people would expect.
Thanks, Trevor.
Thank you.